Welcome to the presentation on finding sums of integers. You're probably wondering why are we doing this within the context of averages? And well, if you think about it, all an average is you take a sum of a bunch of numbers and then you divide by the number of numbers you have. And what we're going to do here is do a couple algebra problems that involve just the sum parts first. And actually, they can carry over into, average problems as well. Let's get started with a problem. Let's say I told you that I had the sum of five consecutive integers. Consecutive integers is equal to 200. What is the smallest? And I apologize for my handwriting. What is the smallest of the five integers? Well, there's a couple of ways to do this, but I guess the most straightforward way is just to do it algebraically, I would say. So let's say that x is the smallest of the integers, right? So x is actually what we're going to want to figure out, smallest of integers. Well, if x is the smallest, what are the other four going to be, right? We have a total of five. Well, they're consecutive. Consecutive just means that they follow each other, like 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All of those are consecutive integers, right? And if you remember, integers are just whole numbers, so it can't be a fraction or a decimal. So if x is the smallest, so then the next integer is going to be x plus 1. And then the one after that is going to be x plus 2. And the one after that is going to be x plus 3. And the one after that is going to be x plus 4, right? And it might seem confusing, I'm writing all of these x's, but if you think about it, if x was 5, then this would be 6, this would be 7, this would be 8, and this would be 9. And that's all I'm writing here, right? So these would be, assuming that x is the smallest of the integers, the 5 integers would be x plus 1, x plus 2, x plus 3, and x plus 4. And we know that the sum of these 5 consecutive integers is 200. Well, what is the sum of these 5, I guess we could say, numbers or expressions? Well, let's see. We have 5 x's, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So x plus x plus x plus x plus x is equal to just 5x, right? Or you could just say 5 times x. And then that's plus 1 plus 2 is 3, 3 plus 3 is 6, 6 plus 4 is 10. So the sum of these 5 integers is going to be 5x plus 10. And all I did is add up the x's and then added up the constants. And we know that that is going to equal 200. And now this is just a level 2 linear equation. We could just solve for x. So we get 5x is equal to 190. I just subtracted 10 from both sides, right? And then x is equal to, let me divide 5 into 190. 5 goes into, let's see, 5 goes into 19 3 times. 3 times 5 is 15. 9 minus 5 is 4. Bring down the 0. 5 goes into 48 times. So x is equal to 38. Pretty straightforward problem, don't you think? Now, what if I were to ask you, what is the average of the 5 consecutive numbers? Well, now, there's two ways of doing this. Now that we already know that x is 38, we know that the other numbers are going to be, well, this is 38, 39, 40, 41, 42. Well, we could just average these four numbers. We could just say 38 plus 39 plus 40 plus 41 plus 42. And well, we already know what those, I don't even have to do the math. We already know that they average up to, they sum up to 200, and then we divide the sum by 5, because there are 5 numbers. So the average is 40. Not 46. The average is 40. And there's a couple of ways you could think about that. One, you see 40 is just the middle number, so that makes sense. And the only time we can really say it's the middle number is when the numbers are distributed evenly around 40, right? If we had a number that was much smaller than 40 or something, you couldn't just necessarily pick the middle number. But in this case, since they're consecutive, it makes sense. And another way we could have done this problem, if you were, say, taking the SAT, and they were to ask you, well, you know, the sum of 5 numbers is 200, what's the average of the numbers? Well, you say, well, all I have to do is divide that 200 by 5, and I'll get 40. Let's do another problem. I'll make it a little bit harder. Let's say the sum of, let's say, 7 odd numbers, the sum of seven odd numbers. And let me make up a good, I hope this one works, I'm going to try to do it in my head, is 217. What is the largest number? Oh, I shouldn't say number. Seven odd integers. It actually becomes a much harder problem if it was just seven odd. Actually, the only things that could be odd are integers anyway, so you can almost assume it. But the sum of seven odd integers is 217. What is the largest of the integers? As you can tell, I'm doing this on the fly. And actually, my wife just diagnosed me with, she thinks I have benign vertigo. I got very dizzy this morning when I went to work, so you have to forgive me for that as well. That's impairing me even more. Well, let's do this problem. Let's say that x is the largest. Then what would the number right below x be? Would it be x minus 1? Well, if x is an odd number, x minus 1 would be an even number. So so in order to get the number right below it, we have to do x minus 2 to get another odd number. Oh, and my apologies. It should say the sum of 7 consecutive odd. I don't know if you assume that. I'm trying my best today to confuse you. So the sum of 7 consecutive odd integers is 217. What is the largest of the integers? So if x is the largest, then the next smallest one would be x minus 2, right? Because it's consecutive odd numbers, not just consecutive, right? So consecutive odd numbers are like 1, 3, 5, 7. You're skipping the evens, right? So that's why you're going up or down by 2, depending how you view it. So the next one down would be x minus 2. Then we'll have x minus 4, x minus 6, x minus 8, x minus 10, x minus 12. I think that's it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Right? Those are 7 numbers. They're separated by 2. X is the largest of them. Right? And we can assume that they're odd because apparently the problem will work out so that they're odd. So what is the sum of these 7 numbers? Well, the 7 x's just add up to 7x. And then let's see, 2 and 4 is 6, 6 is 12, 12 and 8 is 20, 20 and 10 is 30, 30 and 12 is 32. So 7x minus 32 is equal to 217. And we just solve for x. 7x is equal to, let's see, if we add 32 to both sides of this equation, we get 249. Let's see, 7 goes into 249. Is that right? It's 200. Right. So 7 goes into 249. Should I do this addition properly? I want to make sure. 2 plus 4 is 6. 6 plus 6 is 12. 12 plus 8 is 20. 20 plus 10 is 30. 30 plus 12 is 42. Oh, here we go. See, my mathematical spider sense could tell that something was fishy about this. So that's 7x minus 42. And that's, so if we add 42 to both sides, that's 7x is equal to 259. See how brave I am? I do this thing in real time. 259. So 7 goes into 259. Let's see, 7 goes into 25 3 times 7 is 21. 49 goes into 37 times. So we get x is equal to 37. And we're done. So just to review, because I think I kind of had a lot of errors in this problem when I presented it. The question was, the sum of 7 consecutive odd integers is 217. What is the largest of the integers? I said x is the largest. And then if x is the largest, the next smaller one will be x minus 2. Because we're not saying just consecutive integers, we're saying consecutive odd integers, right? So if x is 37, which is what we solved for, then x minus 2 is 35. This is 33. This is 31. This is 29. This is 27, this is 25. And then we just added up all the x's, and then all added up all the constants, and said that, well, they add up to 217, and then we just solved for x. I think you're now ready to try some of these problems. Have fun.